Hi guys, welcome to Cinema Express. My name is Shilajit, Mitra. I'll be getting you up to speed with all the cool stuff that's happening in Hindi cinema out here in Bombay. Hi Emraan, welcome to the show.
Hi, thank you so much.
Emraan, in the last 17 years at least, there's been a decided shift in the kind of image you earlier had to more craftier roles we saw in Shanghai Tigers. Now, it seems to be coming from a very personal and introspective space. Is that correct? Like this decision to, you know, to shift gears?
I think it is a lot to do with my priority shifting, also evolving and changing as an actor, maturing as a person. I think as you go through experiences in your life, it reflects in your creative decisions that you make. And that's true to what's happened with me. I think you can't just do a certain kind of cinema throughout your career because at the end of the day, it just seems very repetitive and you're not variating at all. And there's no creative satisfaction in that. So there has been a deliberate shift because you get a bit tired and you reach a little saturation point with things that you've been doing before. And then there's a need to kind of grow as an actor, as a performer, as a creative person. And then you look for other avenues and other kinds of films that could be risky, but it's very important for your personal growth.
You know, on that note, you know, I'm sure you get this often that, you know, people online mention how similar you sometimes look to a Hollywood actor, Colin Farrell, at times.
Yeah.
Interestingly, though, you know, what's more uncanny to me is how Farrell's early career, he was like that Hollywood, you know, movie star. And now we see him in very meaty, so-called art house, critically acclaimed roles. So do you think there's a natural burning out, leveling out that happens, you know, with actors who might be interested in different cinema, might be doing something else?
Yeah, you know, every actor has his own or her own trajectory that they follow. There's no one particular roadmap that's right. You just do what you feel is right at the end of the day. There's no right or wrong. And this division of commercial, arty films, in the box, out of the box, it's very important for your for an actor to just explore everything. I mean, for our country, you just see there's so many different kinds of audiences. They're divided as the class audience. There is the masses that see a very different kind of films in cinema. You go across a few kilometers in states, across the states, and you have different, you know, people speaking different languages, different cultures. It's a very tricky country to kind of pitch a film, you know, because there's so many different. It's easier to make an English film that you know permeates everywhere across equally universally. So yeah, for me also, I think I've always tried to strike that balance, you know, make films for the masses, which was initially the case. And also right now the idea has been, yes, give them something, give the classes something, and just have a mixed bag of everything.
Coming to Cheat India, and you know, the film addresses something very relevant and it's been around for a long way, but we see that on the big screen. Earlier in a conversation, you mentioned that it's kind of like a Hydra-headed problem with so many aspects and stuff. What got you hooked to this film, the subject of itself, and what was your sort of, you know, insight when you looked at the research material?
I know as a student of the system that how bad it is, how ineffective it has been in my personal life. From the confusion that I faced when I came out of school, I didn't know what profession to get into or what major to take. And that has been the case with mostly all my friends and a lot of people I've spoken to. Should we take science, commerce or arts? And that is never a deciding factor. The school never gives you clarity of what your forte might be. Or just the whole thing of rote mugging, the disinterested teachers. Not that there aren't qualified teachers, but generally because of the pay in our country, there are a lot of teachers who get in this profession that are not qualified. And I didn't know about this, the other aspect of problems that are plaguing our system, which is the cheating mafia. Mm-hmm. There are people, middlemen in every state who take money and get undeserving students' merits. They send their own bunch of scholars to colleges and schools and so that they give examinations for those undeserving students who sit at home. And they get grades. Mm-hmm. And those very students later on become doctors and engineers and whatever, what have you. So I didn't know about that. So it's a revelation for me. It was a revelation for me. And I think it'll be a revelation to a lot of people there who have been, and most of us have been part of the system.
And how enabling was turning producer in terms of, you know, getting this project going?
It was, for me, a great step in the right direction. There was a next step because I felt there were a couple of films of mine. I wasn't very happy with how things came together. I felt a bit powerless because I was only a a participant in it as an actor, which is acting in the film and maybe promoting it. But I think as a producer, you get to see a lot more than that and a part of an overall decision-making process. So after, I've been here for 17 years acting, I felt that the next step would be that, so that I can just really, you know, get to see a project from its nurturing, from the script stage right to its, you know, ultimate release and marketing.
So even coming to a character itself, you know, it's all very interesting whenever you take up these very rooted but, you know, shady characters. What's interesting though is he, you know, there's a confusion, is he out and out an anti-hero per se as we see them in movies, or is he more like a man of the times, you know, of the circumstance, who maybe has a moral awakening? Is it asking too much? Or
you know, everyone is the hero of their own lives. No one really, when you're even doing a devious deed, we seldom are reflective on that. Otherwise, we wouldn't have done it in the first place. So sometimes we have regrets. But he's a guy that we have not tried to find any way justification in this character. He himself doesn't find any justification. He does it. He is unapologetic about what he does. And he has a very brilliant, not brilliant, he has a very interesting philosophy of how he looks at things that he's doing. He says that, listen, I'm giving an opportunity to these kids, even though it is cheating. Your system, and this he's saying to the system out there, it's not really helping these kids. You're pressurizing the kids, you're not giving them an opportunity, you're not giving them seats in universities. So at least I'm giving them an avenue. Mm-hmm. So he says that I'm not a hero, I'm not a villain, I'm just playing a game, and I'm just making money, and it's primarily for greed and just the lust for power. It's as simple as that, and there's no justification for it. He doesn't justify it to anyone. He doesn't need to justify it to anyone else. I'm just doing it for that.
Fair enough. And Emraan, so we just concluded the previous year, and one of the, you know, key talking points had been the digital revolution as such. You've already made your acting digital debut in Tigers.
Yeah.
This Bar of Blood is going to be like your, it's the Netflix premiere show this year. How is it shaping up? How are you?
Good. It's shaping up well. It's we've done, completed around 60-70% of it, and we have the last leg left. We'll release it sometime in August. Exciting one. I've always been a big fan of web shows. I've been a big fan since the past 6 years. I saw Breaking Bad 6 years back. And I've been a fan of the format, because it's like great literature. You get to really sink your teeth into characters and the story. And it's not like it's just a two-hour film. Everything is compressed in a two-hour film. Here you get to do a lot more. But a lot of hard work. It's like shooting three films. And yeah, excited. Waiting for the audience to see it soon.
Emraan, what are you watching right now? Also reading. You famously said that you don't watch enough Bollywood movies as such. So what are you watching on the web space?
I'm watching a web show called You. I don't get too much time to watch too many things because of the promotion and work. But yeah, You is something I'm watching right now.
Okay. Wonderful. Great talking to you, Emraan, and all
Thank
the best
you.
For you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.